Hey guys, welcome to Rockin' the Country. I'm Don, and today I'm doing a reaction to Earl Thomas Conley, and Earl just passed away yesterday, which is why I picked a song to do immediately, just in his honor. And it's a reaction. I don't know the song. I don't even know a lot of Earl's music, but he was requested by a couple of you requested that I do this. Blue Sky, as well as Trenton W, those are the two screen names, requested in the comments last night that, you know, once you found out that he'd passed, that I do this. So that's what I'm doing. He had a heck of a career. He passed away in Nashville at age 77. He was born in Portsmouth, Ohio. And in his career, I think he recorded something like 15 albums. He was a prolific songwriter. He had 18 number ones. How that's measured, I'm not quite sure. Might have been other artists recording some of his as well as some of his own. But in any case, of course, in his honor, I'm not going to rate this song. I don't rate a song, the first song after somebody has passed away. So, and then I use discretion after that. But he was survived by his longtime partner, Carol Skates, and three children. Let's see, I wrote them down. Aaron, Amy, and Ty. So if at any point you see this reaction, if in 5 years or 1 year or whenever you're scouting the net and YouTube presents this video to you as an option and you watch it, my condolences. My mom passed away last year. I had taken care of her for over a year. In her home, and you know, I know what that's like. So anyway, I'm gonna get on with the song. Yeah, that's pretty much, you know, the introduction that I wanted to make, but this is just straight up in Earl Thomas Conley's honor, in honor of you know, a person's life who's no longer with us, but the music lives on, so as do the memories. So here we go. Earl Thomas Conley song, What I'd Say. Don't know this song, so here we go.
Talking to the mirror, whispering your name, just like
yeah.
Think I was insane.
I think we all have done
these
that.
Conversations in the silence of my room, rehearsing all the things I'd say should I run into you.
I think everybody talks to themselves.
How's it going? Might be what I'd say. You broke my heart, you know. Boy, it looks like rain today. Or maybe, God, I missed you since you went away. You're looking well, or go to hell, might be what I'd say.
Yeah, I don't know who did this video. I don't know if it's an official video or if another YouTuber did it as well. But the song, beautiful. The lyrics itself, of course, by the time you've had your heart broken in life, you can relate to these lyrics very well. And depending on the depth of the heartbreak, you don't know what you'd say. I'm not one to pre-think things that much. I do a lot of thinking in my free time, but I don't pre-think, just like on my reaction videos, I don't pre-think what I'm going to say. I just get into them and then roll. Even on my reviews, I don't know what I'm going to say. And same thing in my interactions with folks. I pretty much like freedom. And I don't impose too many strictures on myself even. I have a guiding principle of kindness and all that. So some of the lyrics in here, it's like, I don't know what I would say. Would I say, God, I've missed you, or, and I hope you're well, or would I say, go to hell, you know? I mean, depending on the relationship and how things broke down, any relationship, even if it's with a friend or a colleague or anybody, and you don't know how you're going to react when you see them, you run the gamut of thoughts. And then hopefully you, if you're pre-thinking it, you're going to work out the bad ones. You know, you don't want to go, hey, go to hell. You know, like, that's kind of rough. But I guess it depends on how badly you got burned, too. I mean, sometimes those are your feelings, but sometimes there are no words whatsoever. All right, let's go on with this here. This, I'm relating to these lyrics and very well.
There's times I feel so angry, I put my fist right through the wall.
And there.
And then there's times I've come so close to giving you a call. I love you and I hate you all at the same time. I pray that you come back to me before I lose my mind.
That's honest.
How's it going? Might be what I'd say. You broke my heart, you know. Oh, it looks like rain today. Oh, maybe, God, I missed you since you went away. You're looking well, or go to hell. Might be what I'd say.
Just pause there too. I wonder, you know, when you're writing a song, when you're the lyricist and you're coming up with the lyrics, there's so many options you've got because there's nothing there and you're relying on your own creativity. You're writing based on your own experience in life. It's hard to get away from that aspect. And so there are so many things that you could say, you know, God, I've missed you, or have you been, or, you know, did you meet anybody? I mean, all the thoughts you could come up with. And in a song, you've got to write something down. And so ultimately, he went with this and ran the gamut of, God, I've missed you, please come back, or go to hell. I mean, and that kind of depicts the human condition when our hearts and minds are just spinning. Who can even explain all that? But it's sort of like, from here to God, I hate you. God, I love you. and he captured it. I mean, that's the human condition.
Guess you'll have to wait until that day to find out what I say.
Yeah. Yeah, that, I'm glad I picked that song because I thought of multiple things while listening to it, but it's a bold move to capture that gamut of emotions in a song. Not only was I thinking about the song itself, but I was thinking about a man whose life, he just passed away yesterday, what he left us with and the imprint. And there was a boldness in this song. I mean, it was a ballad. It was a heart-wrenching ballad, but it was so honest. It's like, I don't know if I'm going to say this really beautiful thing, and I really want you back, but I'm also thinking, God, I hate you. But that's speaking to the pain he's in. I don't think he hates her. He hates the fact that she put him in this pain. Who was at fault? We don't know. That's, you know, doesn't even matter in the context of this song. It's just he's feeling this and the honesty, and I love that. And I love that being the impression that I get from reacting to his first song. Because honesty is a biggie. When you're honest about what you yourself, and you reveal what you yourself are thinking and feeling, and you're just honest about whatever it is, your weaknesses, your strengths, you know, your shortcomings, your talents, you know, all the things that make us who we are, but to be honest with them, instead of defending and trying to say, no, I don't have weaknesses, or no, I'm not thinking this bad thought, or no, you know, we go to defense mode. He just came out with a broken heart in here and said, I don't know what I wish you'd come home so I could sort this all out and get it done with. I don't know what I'm going to say, but I'd like to know. So anyway, all right. Blue Sky and Trenton W. specifically, you know, but for everybody who knows Earl Thomas Conley's music and for his family, this is just in honor of him and his life. It's what I, as a reviewer and reactor, can do, you know, and this is what I wanted to do. You know, I picked this song out. So there it is. Earl Thomas Conley's song, What I'd Say. And that's it, guys. Thanks for watching. I'll see you on another video. Keep rocking the country. And I guess we'll all be mindful of Earl Thomas Conley today and in the weeks and months to come. And there it is. Have a great day.